Radio Cardiff. 98.7 FM.
Good afternoon. You're listening to the News, Views and Interviews on Radio Cardiff 98.7 FM. I'm Jane Morris. Now, apparently over 30 of us say we struggle to find time to spend with our friends and family. But could that have something to do with the fact that we just never organise anything? And almost 50% of Brits have blamed the lack of money as the main reason for their absence of a social life. But is this just an excuse? Surely meeting up with our nearest and dearest doesn't have to cost the earth. Is the real reason due to waiting for someone else to organise our social lives for us? Well, to tell us more about the survey and maybe a little bit about her social life, we've got Cherry Healy on the line. Hello.
Hello, Jane. How are you today?
I'm good, thanks. How are you?
I'm very good. Yes, this research is quite interesting, isn't it?
It is, yes. I'm just assuming you have this wonderful, really active social life.
No, when I read this research, I did feel a bit challenged, actually, because I suppose I go through phases, but I do quite often leave it. I've got an amazing friend called Eugenie, and she is the doer. She has got her finger on the cultural pulse. And I just always think, well, I don't know if I've got the time, and I just slightly leave it to her because I know that every so often she's going to send an email rallying us all together, taking us to a new restaurant or gig or festival, and I kind of don't need to bother. So I did make myself a promise. Okay, I'm not just going to leave it to her. I'm going to take it on myself to reciprocate her wonderful gestures and organise something myself. It's so satisfying, and actually it's really easy with sites and mobile apps. It doesn't need to break the bank. I can understand that a lot of these exciting, you know, events that we see on Instagram and we all get a bit jealous, and Facebook, you know, they are quite expensive, but if you use a good site, you can get great deals. If you rally a group together, it doesn't need to cost the earth, and it does have such a positive impact on your life.
Yeah, so in this server, they've kind of split people up, haven't they, into doers. They're the ones who organise everything, and everyone else, and maybe the unreliable latecomer as well.
We've also got the dropouts, the forgetters,
yes,
and the latecomers, and actually, the worst of all is the dropouts. You know, better late than never, okay. The forgetter, well, there we go. But the dropouts, the people who say yes and then don't turn up, it is mortifying. If you've been brave and you've taken the time to organise something and someone doesn't turn up, it can be awful, especially if there's more than one. You know, one, two, three people, they always think the other people are turning up. It's definitely a social sin to do that, I think.
I have to say I agree with that. There's nothing more infuriating than you organise a night out or something and everyone's like, yeah, I'll come. And you go there and then they just don't turn up. And it's like, why didn't you tell me in the first place you weren't coming? Because we'd go somewhere else.
And especially, well, I've got a little girl. She's four. And so you have to organise childcare in the evening. So if you've gone to the event and groups are fun to go out with. So it's not that your presence won't be missed. Of course it will. You know, if it's just you and one other person who's turned up, the dynamic is different. It's just not as fun. It is fun to go out in a big, rowdy group. So I think if you've said you're going to go, I've given myself a little promise. You know, even if it's raining, I'm knackered, just go. I can always go home after 20 minutes. I can say, okay, I can't do this. I can go home. But always turn up.
Yeah, that's it. You just show your face, don't you? We're talking here about groups of friends going out, but is this happening with families as well?
Yes, I think so. I mean, it's always really lovely to... I mean, I see my family a lot. I have got quite a big family. I've got three brothers. And I absolutely love, you know, doing the Sunday lunch at my mum's. It's really fun. But I keep on thinking, actually, you know, we should do something together. We should have a memory together. Because when you go out and you do something different, you've got things to talk about. You've got stories to laugh about. If it's a wonderful experience, then hooray. And if it's actually a bit strange, then that can be brilliant as well. You've got a story to tell. You have an experience together. It's too easy just to do the same thing over and over again and slightly take family for granted. Believe me, I'm a big fan of taking it easy. I'm very good at mooching and just, you know, relaxing. But I think every so often we do need to challenge ourselves to do something that's a bit refreshing.
I usually find that the nights when I really don't feel like going out, but I make the effort and drag myself out, they're usually the best nights that you have.
Couldn't agree more. I went to see The Bodyguard last night, and about 4 o'clock in the afternoon, it was raining, and I just felt really pregnant. I thought, oh, I can't be bothered. And I just thought, just don't do this. Go. Don't you dare pull out. I went. I had the best time. It was really good fun. Everyone showed up. It was a brilliant group. It was a brilliant night out. And I came home with a real spring in my step. And I woke up this morning feeling so energetic, way more energetic than if I'd just slobbed about on my sofa, which I love. But actually, it did. It really paid dividends. So I think it is too easy just to do the same thing again and again. And it doesn't need to break the bank. You can find amazing deals. Mm-hmm. But I think make a promise to yourself, I'm going to get a group of friends together and inject some fun into their lives. I think know your audience as well. I would hate it if someone made me go paintballing, but, food festival, a music festival, know your friends and know what they'll like, and pitch them something that you think they'll have a brilliant time at.
Mm. But there's loads of free things out there to do as well. You just have to look for them.
Yeah, loads of free things. Free things and low-cost events are all over the place. In a way, that can be quite intimidating, but I think make a decision. 2 weeks' time, on Saturday, we're going to go out the afternoon. It can only, a couple of hours. That's all it takes, but it can make the weekend feel like a holiday.
Absolutely. So are people using social media to organise their social lives now?
I think that is one of the joys of the age we're living in, is that you can do it on your mobile. I mean, you can be on the bus, you can go onto Groupon's mobile app, and you can organise an amazing event before you've even got to work. Boom.
Yeah. Done. But don't you find that's like a double-edged sword, though? Because, I get events all the time coming to me on Facebook. It's so easy to just click, yeah, I'm going. But you haven't actually spoken to the person.
Well, that's why I think it should be kept personal. I agree. If I see an event on Facebook, I'm not really that interested in it. And if I do say yes, I feel no duty to go. So it's very much like if I fancy it on the night or not. But I think if you're emailing people personally, you're getting a group of 5 or 10 people together, then people do feel, A, it's more personalised, it's something they're going to really like, and actually there is more of a sense of obligation to go. Mm. You're more likely to have a hoot as well, because it'll be your close friends, I think. And I think, actually, it's much nice to have a personal touch. The problem with social, doing things on social media is, actually, there's no timeline. If you see something in a paper, it's got a beginning and an end date. You have to do it. There's an urgency. I think that's why making yourself a promise, in 2 weeks' time, I'm going to do this, is important. Otherwise, there's never a time when you have to do it.
Mm. So, basically, the personal touch is the way to go.
Personal touch. Make a promise to yourself that you're actually going to do it. Keep the cost down. Make it easy for people to attend.
Mm-hmm. So have you got anything lined up over the next couple of weeks?
Well, I did The Bodyguard last night, which was really fun, but that was organised by someone else. But I do plan to organise. I'm going to take my friends to a food festival.
Ah.
That is what I'm going to do. Jane, can I challenge you to do something with your friends?
I'm sure I will. I'm not sure what yet, but I'm sure I will.
Well, all Jane's friends, watch for the email.
Well, I do tend to rally people from time to time, but yeah.
Are you the doer?
Occasional doer, I'd say. Not the all-the-time doer.
Occasional doer is good.
Yeah, it's all right. Okay, so where can our listeners go for more information?
If you go to groupon.co.uk/delegationnation, there's loads of information there about how to bring joy into your friend's life.
Okay, then. Well, we all need some joy in our lives, don't we?
Don't we all?
Absolutely. Well, Cherry, thank you so much for speaking to us today.
Pleasure, Jane. Thank you so much.
Bye-bye.
All right, bye. Radio Cardiff.